Alright guys, this is Chris G. I'm back with my gaming channel, T.Gameology, and I'm here doing Red Dead Redemption 2. So guys, this will be the 12th mission of this chapter. We're still on chapter 3. And we are going to be doing Blessed Are the Peacemakers. Alright guys, this will be walkthrough 44. In the last couple videos, I was hunting and beefing up the camp with all the hides and stuff. Guys, I did that for a bit in 2 videos and it took longer than I thought, so I did a little bit without recording. And I didn't get it all done, so some of the animals are just crazy hard to get, some of them. Guys, also want to say thank you again for following my channel and supporting my channel. I appreciate all the love. Thank you very much. And also want to say sorry that I haven't put a video out in about 3 weeks. Just this whole COVID-19, things have been a bit crazy at work. And I haven't really had time to be doing walkthroughs. Seem to be work, sleep, eat. Not necessarily in that order, but seems that's all I've been doing for about 3 weeks. Finally, guys. Well, I also had to go to my dad's house and do some work for him. Just seems like I had no time, guys. So I do apologize. But I'm back. And now that I'm back. Like, what are you talking about? You're wearing a shirt, dude. I'm wearing a shirt, a vest, and a jacket. What are you talking about? But anyways, guys. We're gonna do a main mission. Enough screwing around. Enough hunting. But, I did beef some stuff up maybe quickly before we start this mission. I'll show you what I beefed up. Well, I can see one from here. This, rug. Yep. It's a cow rug that I got. Slaughtered a cow. Yep. I just went to the ranch, guys, slaughtered the cow. You become wanted. Yeah, so what? Get on your horse right away, pay the fine. You know how the game, you guys know how the game is. Oh, on my tent, if you guys can see over there, I finally got the gator head. Rams are hard to get. That was the other head that's supposed to go up there. Oh, antlers on the tree right there. I'll put that there. I think they're moose antlers. No. Stop your BS, bud.
This'll help the stew. Might as well keep the reserves as full as we can. Good job, Mr. Morgan. I've come up with some ideas for ways we could improve things.
There you go. So for me, I got the alligator and the board table. Cougar and ram, they're hard to get. God, Jesus. Never went after the ox. Though I did see one somewhere. Oh, we got some boars for John's tent. A boar rug. Yup, we got the camp tables done. The chuck wagon done. Oh, some main. Main campfire stuff. What was this one? Whoa. We got one, I need two. Damn. What's this? Fox.
I'll need you to go find me the right materials before I can make
beaver. I haven't even seen a muskrat or a beaver yet, but okay. Two snake and I got one. Jesus. Alright guys, so you're seeing the upgrade I made. I never did anything in here. I don't know if I will. Maybe later. So anyways, I just wanted to show you guys that. And like I said, what the hell? Guys, like I said, this is the main mission. Blessed are the peacemakers. Let's do this.
Blessed are the peacemakers. They shall be called.
Hey, Molly, where's Dutch?
Well, however it goes.
I'm not sure all that line of thought serves you and me very well.
That's because, Cowpoke, you are a man of profoundly limited intelligence.
No doubt.
Well, you and the old man and Dutch have been running around, digging us ever deeper into shit. Old Mr. Pearson might have gone and lightened the load of it. Pearson! Aren't you curious?
Yes, gentlemen.
Dutch, you tell him, fat man.
It's peace, Dutch. The O'Driscolls. I mean, I think there's a way.
What on earth are you talking about?
Get the words out properly, fat man.
I met a couple of the O'Driscoll boys. They rode in the town. Things were about to get ugly. But you know how I am in a fight, huh? Like a corner tiger. Anyway, somehow it didn't, but we got to talking. They suggested a parlay to end things. My gentlemen.
Combe O'Driscoll. Have you lost your minds?
Always telling us, Dutch, do what has to be done, but don't fight wars in your fight.
They want a parlay? It's a trap.
Well, of course, it's probably a trap, but what do we got to lose finding out?
Get shot.
We ain't getting shot because you'll be protecting us. It's a trap, we shoot a lot of them. If it ain't a trap, that's slim chance.
I don't see the point in any of this.
It's a chance we've gotta take.
I killed Combe's brother a long time ago. Then he killed a woman I loved dear.
As you say, it's a long time ago, Dutch.
Let's go. You and me, with Arthur protecting us, no one else.
What about me?
This ain't the time for tigers, my friend.
You know what else happened, guys? Well, I was hunting. My horse died. So I'm on my third horse. I don't like this horse, to be honest with you.
You know, I've been fighting Calm for so long now, I can barely remember a time when it was different.
You're still fighting him now. Make no mistake of that.
Here he goes. Got Hunting Tommy. Is there any plan you ain't sour on?
Maybe you're right. Just nervous. Let's not waste any more lives needlessly.
I ain't costing lives here. I'm saving them. What did you say? We had Pinkertons coming after us.
Because of Blackwater.
And Leviticus Cornwall and his private army. Then who knows when this local hillbilly thing will come to a head. And we really... afford to be fighting on all these.
He just ran over an animal. What the hell was that? Fox, maybe?
I hope so, gentlemen, but like I said, I'm nervous.
Look, you ain't even going to be the one in danger. So get on over there, find a nice perch for you to settle into. You got that rifle, don't you?
Yeah.
And me and Judge walk right in. Lion's den with you to cover us.
Okay, just keep calm so I give you a reason not to.
Oh, we'll be fine. We got you.
I will do my best.
Oh, my dear and trusted friend, with you watching over me, I would walk into hell itself.
As would I.
Of this great nation, men created equal. worth trying for. It is worth believing in. Can't you see that, friend?
I don't know.
Try. All I ask is you try.
Out. Let's aim to meet back at the fork in the road afterwards.
We'll be there, partner.
Yeah.
That was fucked up.
Dutch.
It's been a while.
Sure.
So, how's your gang doing?
I still believe it in you.
Better world.
Pure world. How's that coming along?
Just fine.
How's that score you stole off us?
Which one?
Oh, I like that. It's like I said, this is a charismatic leader.
A lot of heat on us this time. Look at us. Whole heap of trouble.
They offered me a price, Dutch?
When you eat?
Why didn't you take it?
Well, still mine.
I am sorry about your brother.
Yeah, well, I never liked him much.
Liked.
Y'all always love the ladies, Dutch Vanderlyn.
I like that about you.
What are we doing here, Cole? Is this thing over?
Oh.
What the fuck?
Put his weapons over there.
You crazy.
What the hell?
That was messed up, guys.
I thought I'd be burying you, Mr. Morgan.
Well, not quite yet, Reverend.
Good. How you feeling?
Oh, about the same as you.
I'm sorry to hear that. Well, take care of yourself.
You too.
Well, that was crazy, guys.
Ooh.
What?
A man of words, not of action. Hardly a man at all.
Well, I think you're as slippery as an eel in an oil slick, but still a man.
Because I think I've found something interesting.
Yeah?
Have you ever robbed a stagecoach?
Oh, never. I would have even thought. Of course I robbed a goddamn stagecoach. You know I have.
And what's the problem with stagecoaches?
The armed man attempting to put a bullet in your head?
Not quite. The odds. I mean, is it worth the robbing? I know. But, well, if you'd like to come with me, I can introduce you to a new best friend, and he's going to give you all the decent, robbable stagecoaches a hot-blooded degenerate could require.
I could require a whole lot. So where do we find this friend of yours?
Rhodes.
Because what can possibly go wrong there?
Well, lead the way and we'll find out. Well, let's go then.
Not when you're riding me into the goddamn tree, you fool.
She was just talking about something.
I can ask the same of you. I have a few commitments over this way. Some expenses to meet.
Expenses? What expenses? Gentlemen's canes and rabbits to pull out of hats?
Among other things, I had quite a nice little business going for a while. Shares in a gold mining company. Excellent returns for the investor of a certain financial standing. Until, well, that unfortunate run-in with the law.
Yeah, that's how it goes. Thanks for disappearing on us during that Sean business, by the way.
I've done my part. Each to their strengths, dear boy. You know, you boys should really watch yourselves with those two families. This is a small town. People talk. I tried to mention it to Osea, but you know how he is. Here we are. We can hitch up outside. I'll make the introduction drop.
You guys, obviously, this is the next chapter.
Come on, hang back a bit and let me do the talking. We don't want to scare him off. Oh, I almost forgot. Bill asked me to give you a message to meet him in town as soon as you can. Something to do with the graves. I thought I'd nab you first.
Yeah? Okay. Thanks.
Ain't you kind, sir?
Call him Arthur. He's one of us, a fellow man of distinction.
Okay. Well, this is perfect timing. I think you'll like this one, Josiah.
It'll be coming south down the River Road through Siltwater Strand.
Thank you, Alden. Thank you very much.
Oh, and Josiah, if you or Arthur are ever out Strawberry Way, ask for my colleague there. They're called Hector. He's also one of the... What did you call us again?
Discouraged men.
That's it. Discouraged men. I like that.
Well, goodbye, Alden. Or should I say... adieu.
Oh, adieu, Josiah.
Siltwater Strand.
Okay. I think I know a good spot to wait. Follow me. Mount up, then. Let's go.
Safe than sorry. What were you thinking?
Well, according to this, the loot is located in a strongbox, which is in the back. I'll put on a little performance, and you can scurry around, open the strongbox, and relieve them of their goodies.
And how do I open the strongbox without threatening someone to open it for me?
This should work.
And I can do this silently?
Well, I'm hoping complete silence won't be necessary, but you're going to wish you had your earplugs. This is damn.
Oh, very good, Alden, very good.
Of course, if anything goes wrong, you can wave your guns around like you normally do. Hold tight. They'll be here soon. There it is. Right on time. Let's go. Keep your distance so they don't see you. And please leave that gun in its holster for once.
Yeah. It's a free bet.
Well done, sir. Well done.
It was easy. You did all the work.
Teamwork, my dear boy. Teamwork.
Here you go.
Thank you. Oh, don't worry. Go see Alden from time to time. See you soon, Arthur.
Sorry, guys. I'm gonna end this video here, and we'll come back with another video shortly. We just did two missions in this walkthrough, so just thinking of doing them separately, but this one was pretty quick, so why not? And right now, I'm just gonna go to the stable, guys, see if I can get a different horse. As I told you at the beginning of this video, I don't really like this horse. So I'll probably do that off recording and come back and do the next mission, which is meet Bill in town. I think it's called a walk in the, a friendly walk in town or something like that. Alright, guys, so once again, I appreciate all the love and support, and I'll be back shortly with another video. And this time, I promise, guys, it won't be 3 weeks. All right, guys. So I'll see you shortly. One love. And peace out.